Test. Check. Test.
certified senior from Atlanta, Georgia, number 5, Savon Traylor. At forward, 6'7 senior from Winnebago, Nebraska, number 10, David Wittgen Jr. At the other forward, 6'7 junior from Shiley, Nebraska, number 50, Christian Tidien. And at the other forward, 6'7 junior from Council Bluffs, Iowa, number 55, Amir Pope. Through is coached by Roman Gentry. And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing your Pioneers! Starting at our 6'1 junior from Moraine, Ohio, number 5, Ed Wright! At the other guard, 6'2 sophomore from Harriman, Utah, number 12, Brenton Van Dyke! At the other guard, 6'5 senior from Alaska, Kansas, number 25, Anthony Brown. At forward, 6'9 senior from Kansas City, Missouri, number 23, Taylor Jones McCreary. And at the other forward, 6'7 freshman from Barcelona, Spain, number 42, Gerard Bosch. The Pioneers are coached by Adam Hefner, assisted by Hudson Welty and Jacob Brennan. Tonight's referees are David Highfield, Scott Payton, and William Sims.
Well, welcome back into the Cook Center on the campus of Mid-American Nazarene University, where we're set for the semifinal game of the Heart of America Conference Tournament between your hosts, the Heart regular season conference champs, the Pioneers, and the visiting Peru State Bobcats in town from Nebraska. So these two teams met twice in the regular season, Pioneers victorious in both. Of course, they were victorious in just about all of their Heart Conference games, 22-2 in league play. Only two losses coming when Ed Wright was out of the lineup with an ankle injury. Have not been beat since. But Peru State playing for their playoff lives. Pioneers already guaranteed a spot in the national tournament. Peru likely has to win this conference tournament to get in. And certainly capable. This is a big athletic team, and they can shoot it from the three-point line. And a perfect start for the Bobcats as Amir Pote got a switch inside, got the layup to go, and he was fouled. And that's a quick foul on the big fella, Caleb Jones McCreary, who was just named first team all-conference, deservingly so, as well as all-defensive team. And staying out of foul trouble is going to be crucial for Caleb. Of course, we'd be remiss not to mention Ed Wright, also first team all-conference, and Anthony Brown, not only first team all-conference again, but the conference player of the year and defensive player of the year. So just an outstanding season from your Pioneers. But postseason play underway. Peru got to the semifinal game by winning at Central Methodist. It's a big-time win as Ed Wright gets downhill on the right-hand layup attempt off the mark. Comes Peru State in transition. It's Carlos Hines, the 6'4 guard from Chicago, goes coast to coast, lays it in for two. Couldn't have scripted it any better if you're Coach Gentry on the Bobcats sideline, a 5-0 start a minute in. Bosch lost it on the way up. Pioneers had an easy 2-on-1 there, and Gerard Bosch just lost it in his right hand. He's a lefty, slipped on the way up. Wingett Jr., Division I transfer, kicks it to Tidien up top, and Christian Tidien's three left just short. Pioneers fortunate. Tidien, a capable three-point shooter, shoots it at 35% from down there. This is a huge lineup, Peru State starts. 6'5", 6'5", 6'6", 6'7", 6'7". There's not a true small player on the floor in all of their bigs, with the exception of Amir Pote. Shoot the three-pointer and shoot it well. Can present some unique challenges for you as Tidien picks up his first personal. Van Dyke will inbound on the baseline, goes to Jones McCreary at the elbow. Zoom action, right, kicks back to Bosch. All alone on the wing, Gerard Bosch takes the three, left is short. Long rebound finds Ed Wright from way downtown, and he takes a deep three off the mark. The
This Peru State team will play a much more deliberate pace. Pioneers want to get out and run, scoring over about 90 a game. Wingett Jr. off the pro cut. Peru running a little continuity ball screen here. Started it with a pro cut for Wingett, and then they get to their high-low look, and ball screens on the wings. Late shot clock now. It's going to be Hines. Throws it up over the top. Ed Wright switched onto the big Pote inside. Kicks it out for Wingett Jr., and his three is well off the mark. And the Bobcats come up with an offensive rebound, and Amir Pote, with nobody around him, throws one down. And the Pioneers going to turn it over in the backcourt as Savon Traylor picked up full court, applying some pressure. Pioneers were not ready for it. Jones McCurry stepped over the end line. And this is a team, probably the hottest team in the country, won 17 in a row, wrapped up the conference championship, and have really been blowing people out. Been put on their heels here to start this one. Carlos Hines had a wide open three, strong off the backboard, no good. And there's another turnover. Van Dyke was looking for Anthony Brown over the top, and nobody home. 7-0 start for Peru State, and it could be worse. Hines walks it across the timeline. Gets it to Traylor. They're looking to go right back inside to Pote, who's guarded by Ed Wright. Ed giving up significant size there. And that may be strategic by the Pioneers, as they might be okay with him taking a lot more shots tonight than he typically does, because you don't want that guy taking too many. Savon Traylor knocks down a three, which he does at about 45%. A sniper from downtown. It is a 10-0 lead to start this one for Peru State College. And that's another turnover. It'll be Bobcat basketball. Again, these two teams have met twice, but in a bit of a different look. Carlos Hines was not on the floor the first time these two teams met, and I could be mistaken, but I don't think Wingett Jr. played the second time they met. Pioneers won both by double figures. This is a Peru State lineup that can really cause some problems. Switch everything 1 through 5 defensively. Going to have mismatch on the inside. There comes Van Dyke on the double team. They just about got a steal. They'll get the turnover. Pioneers waited until David Wingett put that basketball on the floor. Didn't show a double team right away. And then came with the hard double team as soon as he dribbled it. Forced the turnover. And now they've got to do something on the offensive end here. One of the best offensive teams in the country. Been quiet early. Isolation at the elbow for Anthony Brown. He had his shot blocked by Wingett. Jake Alexander in off the bench, collects the offensive rebound. Steal an extra possession that the Pioneers desperately need. Here's Ed Wright off the split cut. Had the pass deflected. Got it back for a moment. Hines is all over him. And Carlos Hines wrapped him up from behind. Could make an argument that should be an intentional foul as Hines wrapped him up from behind the neck. This is a Peru State team that is absolutely playing for their season. Foul was on the floor. Pioneers inbound underneath. Switching, causing some problems, but they get it to Jones McCrary. Alexander puts it on the deck. Cut off by Tidian. Van Dyke drives baseline, and he's stopped there by Traylor. One-on-one defense has been outstanding for the Bobcats here early, and Van Dyke turns it over. Traveled on the baseline. Just 4.5 minutes gone here. Pioneers still scoreless. Team that led the Heart of America in offensive efficiency this season. They'll get it going at some point. Hines with a step-back jumper over Van Dyke, no good. Anthony Brown going to push, crosses over, kicks out to Van Dyke, and they're going to get it right back in the post. Division I transfer, Wingett Jr. on Conference Player of the Year, Anthony Brown. All kinds of ball pressure being applied by the Bobcats early. Brown to that right hand, missed it, and the putback dunk was there and just hit the back rim. Alexander was doing his job, crashing the offensive glass, and just couldn't get the follow-up to go in. Wingett off the dribble handoff, fires up a three, left it way short. He's missed two threes badly, but that's uncharacteristic. He is an excellent three-point shooter, almost 40%. And Peru State going to take a full timeout. Pioneers talk things over and reset. 15:03 to play in the first half. 10-0 Peru State. So Van Dyke brings it across. Peru State showing zone coming out of the timeout. The team plays predominantly man-to-man, giving a different look out of the timeout, but they left Anthony Brown all alone. And his top of the key three rattles out, but Branton Van Dyke crashing the offensive glass was fouled on the putback attempt, and he's going to go to the line for two. Gets the Pioneers on the scoreboard. The sophomore point guard from Herman, Utah, breaks the five-minute scoreless streak at the line. And we'll see Ajante Hogan for the first time for Peru State enter the game. He's another one of these guys, stands 6'5" and shoots 40% from the three-point line. He just got a host of them. Van Dyke 2-for-2 with the line. Pioneers have strung some stops together now. To continue to do it on the defensive end as Pioneers switching ball screens out of necessity, not necessarily their first option, but if they're hit with a screen, there comes a switch. And Caleb Jones-McCurry got the defensive rebound and had it stolen away from behind. Anthony Brown comes up with the steal. He's ahead of everyone. Hines chasing, and he's fouled hard by Carlos Hines. Anthony going to go to the line for two. And that's going to be the second on Hines. So that is a big foul for Peru State. He handles the ball in every single possession. He stands 6'5", but essentially plays the point guard spot for this Bobcat team. And he's going to have to take a seat with those two fouls, so we'll see Skylar Wilson check into the ballgame. The first player in a Bobcat uniform standing anything less than 6'5". Wilson, a 6'2 junior guard out of Omaha, Nebraska. Another guy that shoots it very well from the three-point line. Almost 50%. Anthony capitalizes at the line, and it's a 10-4 game now. There's a travel out top on Savon Traylor. There's the Pioneer student section starting to get into it, trying to give these guys a little bit of life. The winner of this game will play the winner of Graceland and Baker. Should be an excellent game, two evenly matched teams for the Hart Conference Championship, tournament championship, I should say. Great pass inside. Jones-McCurry to cutting Jake Alexander, and Alexander's turnaround no good. I feel like there's been some significant contact in the paint both ways. Not a ton of fouls called on shooting attempts anyway. Wilson gets into the paint, working on Van Dyke. He dropped one off for Pote. Should have been a layup, but Pote. Ooh. The officials just absolutely missed two Bobcats tackle Jake Alexander near midcourt, and Jake was going to track down that full court pass from Anthony Brown. And officials just missed it as they had their eye on the basketball, and that's a shame because would have been an easy layup for Alexander if that did not take place. But the jump ball anyway, it's going to be Pioneer basketball. Possession arrow in their favor. Shot clock should reset here. as it was Peru State basketball. The shot clock's at 7. Looks like officials are going to conference about it now. Another thing of note, Division I transfer and all-conference player David Wingett Jr., 18 points a game scorer, got up awfully gingerly after that dog pile. I don't know if he tweaked an ankle. He's staying in the game, which is a good thing, but could cause some issues for the Bobcats if he's not 100%. Brown, turnaround jumper off too strong, but Jake Alexander once again crashing the offensive glass, and now it's Brayton Van Dyke to the rim. The layup's good and one. Well, Van Dyke going to go back to the free throw line. Lost his shoe in the process. So Brayton's got to put the right shoe back on before he can shoot his bonus free throw as Brooks Langer checks in for the first time. And credit Van Dyke for a tough finish, but that basket is all Jake Alexander fighting the offensive glass, keeping the possession alive. He's stolen a couple of them. And Pioneers have tightened things up on the defensive end. Peru State been stuck on 10 for some time now, and it's a one-possession game. 10-7. Van Dyke has 5, and Pioneers show 2-2-1 zone. Like to fall back into a 2-3 out of this little press. Often comes after made free throws, and they're going to get Anthony Brown on a personal foul coming from behind. He was trying to poke it away from Skylar Wilson, and Wilson cut him off with the body, and Anthony picks up his first. Pioneers are in the 2-3 zone look. And Anthony Brown just about stole that pass back to the top of the key. Got a hand on it. And that's a strong take inside from Ajante Hogan for 2. Went right at a really good defender in Jones McCurry, but Caleb with that early foul doesn't want to pick up a second. Pioneers go inside to Jones McCurry on the block, one-on-one with Pote. Help comes, and he finds a cutting Jake Alexander. Would have been a layup. That was a low pass. Went off the leg of Jake Alexander. It was last touched by Peru State. The Pioneers will keep possession with 14 on the shot clock, and we'll see Ty Griggs enter the ballgame for the first time. Quick inbounds play, get Jones McCurry inside. Wild reverse layup, no good in traffic. Here comes Skylar Wilson. He's going to take it coast to coast. And he was fouled by Van Dyke. Couldn't get the layup to go, but he'll go to the line for 2. Skylar Wilson connects on the first. It's first point of the ballgame. Has played less minutes since the addition of Carlos Hines, but those 2 fouls on Hines, we may see a lot of Skylar Wilson here in the first half. Anthony Brown up top gets a flat ball screen from Jones McCurry. Bobcats switch it. Langer trying to go inside to Jones McCurry. Now they get it to Alexander at the elbow, and Jake's 15-foot jumper, no good. Jones McCurry battling for that rebound, unable to pull it down in traffic, and it's Bobcat basketball. And Mid-America going to get out of that press and zone look, go back to their man-to-man defense here. Gerard Bosch enters back into the game for the Pioneers. Back screen, chase into a ball screen. Kicked out for Ajante Hogan, 3 from the wing. No good. Bosch tipped it to Anthony Brown, and his full court outlet brought in by Jones McCrary and then poked out of bounds by Skylar Wilson. So nice job by Caleb just to catch that ball, and then Skylar Wilson came flying from behind to save a would-be layup, pokes it out of bounds. And it is a low-scoring first 10 minutes of this one. It's a football score, 14-7. To Pioneer's offense will wake up at some point. They go right inside to Jones McCurry. Got a switch, but Wingett Jr. capable in the paint. That's a nice move from the big fella. Your first team all-conference five-man, Caleb Jones McCrary. Pinned Wingett deep, and then just a nice drop step to the left side for the easy two. Pioneer's having to switch some of these dribble handoff exchanges. Savon Traylor into the paint, shot fake. Got Alexander off his feet, but Jake able to recover, forces the miss, and comes up with the rebound. Fortunate that time as Traylor had a pretty clean look inside. Anthony Brown the other way. Too strong on the floater, and here comes Traylor in transition. Brooks Langer gets back, cuts him off, forces the miss, but another offensive rebound from Griggs, and his shot's blocked by Alexander. Good transition defense from Brooks Langer and Jake Alexander, saving not one but two easy looks inside. Wilson crosses over, gets all the way to the rim for two. It's a nice take from Skylar Wilson. He's got 4 points now. We'll see Anthony Brown get a ball screen from Jones McCrary. The Pioneers want to post this switch, looking to go high-low. Bosch has it at the high post. And he's fouled by the much smaller Ty Griggs. The Pioneers trying to get it inside to Jones McCrary. They may flip that and try to go high-low to Bosch if he's going to continue to be guarded by the 6'2 Ty Griggs. Ed Wright back into the game for Alexander. I think that may be a short stint on the bench as Jake has provided much of the energy the Pioneers desperately needed. Jones McCrary out of the high post. Goes up top to Gerard Bosch, and there's Bosch with the finish and one. Just what the broadcaster ordered. A high-low flip from Jones McCrary to Gerard Bosch, and Bosch going to go to the line for the bonus free throw. That's the second foul on Amir Pote, and seventh team foul on Peru State. So halfway through the first half, Pioneers are in the bonus the rest of the way. You can credit Peru State for their intensity early on, but fouls starting to pile up now. The freshman from Barcelona, Spain knocks down the free throw. It's a 16-12 game. Under 10 media timeout coming. And fellow freshman Isaiah Cole enters the game. Cole guards Wilson out top, although Pioneers show 2-3 zone. High post catch for Pote, working on the much smaller Ed Wright there, but Wright forces the turnover. That's last touched by Wilson. Excellent job defensively that time by your Pioneers. It's a four-point ball game, and we'll head to the under 10 media timeout. You're watching the Heart of America Conference Tournament semifinal game, Peru State 16, Pioneers 12. Anthony Brown still running the point guard duties for now. Van Dyke has checked himself into the scorers table, and he'll be in at the next dead ball as Gerard Bosch on the pick and roll converts on the right-handed jump hook. Anthony Brown the assist, and it's a two-point ball game. Pioneers staying in the press back to zone. It's Cole and Anthony Brown up top, Brooks Langer and Ed Wright on the wings, and it's Gerard Bosch manning the middle now with Jones McCreary on the bench. Pioneers not going to provide a lot of help when Pote has it in the paint. They're going to be content with him shooting it there. Stay home on all these 40% three-point shooters from Peru State. It's Griggs, late shot clock now, driving on Anthony Brown, and he dropped off a nice pass for Pote, who missed the layup, and that's why Pioneers not providing a lot of help when he has the basketball. We want him taking a lot of shots as Gerard Bosch sends Ajante Hogan's shot back from where it came in the corner. Bosch off and running. Had it deflected by Traylor, but kicks out to Brooks Langer for three. He left it way short. Anthony Brown ties the game at 16, but you can credit that basket to Isaiah Cole. The Olathe Northwest graduate freshman grabbed the offensive rebound and poked it to Anthony Brown for the easy deuce. Pioneers stay in the zone. High post catch now for Hogan, and he'll just turn and shoot, knocks it down. Ajante Hogan, a 50% field goal shooter, scoring 12 a game off the bench, and he's pretty comfortable in that elbow area. Empty side double ball screen for Brown. Skips to the corner. Cole going to feed the post, and Bosch play one-on-one with Hogan inside. Turns baseline, cut off. And then steps through, and Gerard Bosch with his third straight bucket. This one with the right hand, maybe all of them with the right hand. The lefty showing some versatility, and we're tied at 18. Hogan to Ty Griggs on the wing. Langer met him there. Pioneers stay in the zone. It's Wilson working on Isaiah Cole. And now Langer switched onto the basketball. Pioneers are going to force another turnover. That's a travel on Hogan. The coaching staff, Adam Hefker and Hudson Welty, can't say enough good things about the defense of Isaiah Cole, a freshman who's maybe the best athlete on the team. Keeps the basketball in front, and he's forced a couple of turnovers on the defensive end here. It was a 10-0 start for the Bobcats. It's an 18-8 run ever since. Van Dyke back into the game. Anthony Brown going to take his first breather. Brin, the two-man game, got downhill and left the floater way short. Christian Titian corrals the rebound. And Carlos Hines back in for Peru State with those two fouls to see if the Pioneers can go at him, try to get him to pick up a third before the half. Division I transfer out of Chicago. Griggs, shot fake, found a wide open Wingett Jr. That's not the guy you want to leave open, but he's now 0-for-3 from downtown. Pioneers fortunate, that's another good look. Wright spins, drops it off to the big man, Jones McCreary, and he's fouled from behind by Ty Griggs. He's going to send Caleb Jones McCreary to the free throw line for two. Griggs can't believe it. He did get a lot of basketball up top. Officials are saying there was too much contact down low. Caleb Jones McCreary at the line, 22. Caleb, a much improved free throw shooter this season from a year ago, steps to the line, knocks down the first. And Jake Alexander will come back in for Cole. And after the made free throws, Pioneers hop back into the press. And Jake Alexander steals the inbound and scores the bucket and one. That is the third foul on Carlos Hines. And the Pioneers have taken the lead. Jake Alexander going to find himself at the free throw line for one more. That is a huge play for so many reasons. The turnover and the bucket are great. But the third foul on Carlos Hines can't be overstated. And now a 5-point lead. And Pioneers hop right back into that 2-2-1 press. Van Dyke closing out hard to Wingett Jr. He's 0-for-3 from downtown, but a 40% three-point shooter. Now it's Wingett in the post with point guard Van Dyke on him, but he kicks out to another sharpshooter and Savon Traylor. Traylor misses the three. Pioneers have matched up man-to-man after the offensive rebound, and Titian gets it inside. Had it blocked from behind by Alexander, and he's going to be whistled for the foul. It's the first personal on Jake. Just the fourth team foul on your Pioneers. As Mid-American Nazarene will be in the double bonus the remainder of the half, and Peru with some work to do before reaching the 1-1. It's a good foul, all things considered, because Christian Titian, just a 50% free throw shooter. And there you go, at least saved you one. Alexander with no fouls at the time, you'll take that trade-off. And the 6'7 junior from Omaha, Nebraska, gets his first points of the ball game. It's a 4-point lead now for the Pioneers. Ed Wright looking to refuse that ball screen on the wing. Instead has to use it because he lost it for a moment, and he had it poked away from behind. Skylar Wilson causes the turnover. Pioneers unable to set up that press back to zone. They're matched up man-to-man. Hogan splits the double team off the ball screen. Got all the way to the rim, but Gerard Bosch met him there and forced the miss. Van Dyke in transition. Little step-up screen from Ed Wright, and now Ed calling for a ball screen. Titian is denying Jones McCurry that elbow catch. Pioneers run a lot of offense out of that elbow high post catch. Caleb unable to get it there. And physical play on the block that time. But Bosch turns it over. Wingett Jr. standing his ground inside. Wilson, a cutting Christian Titian. Good ball movement from the Bobcats. Pioneers able to rotate. And Ed Wright got a piece of the basketball but fouled Ajante Hogan from behind. That's just the first on Ed. Oh, excuse me. They're going to get Van Dyke, and that's his second. Fifth team foul on the Pioneers. Pioneers leading scorer, Ed Wright, the junior from Lorain, Ohio. First team all-conference performer. Put up 35-plus multiple times this year. Average of 20 a game, has been held scoreless here in the first 5 minutes. Hasn't got a lot of field goal attempts off, but you can credit some really outstanding ball pressure from Peru State. The Pioneers will look to get Ed going. He's going to come to the top of the key off a staggered double. Was denied by Wilson, got it anyway, and now he gets right to the cup for the easy two. That's what you need. See, a great scorer just needs to see one go in, even if it's a layup. That basket gets a lot wider. 25-20 lead, under five to go in the first half. Wingett Jr. drives baseline with the up and under finish. That is a tough finish from Wingett Jr., but he gets up hobbling once again. That's bad news for the Bobcats. Jones McCurry all alone for the dunk off the pick and roll. Anthony Brown and Jones McCurry perfectly executed two-man game. Little empty side ball screen. Low man in help was late coming over to the roller. And Jones McCrary throws one down for the easy two. Caleb's got six. Pioneers lead by five. Wilson refusing a ball screen for Wingett. He wants the pick and pop there. Now Pioneers have to switch. Too much contact. Wingett drives hard inside, and he's fouled. Well, whatever injury is hampering him between the three-point lines, it seems to go away when he's got the ball in his hands. Plenty quick first step, and follows a pretty ridiculous scoop finish with another strong take to the rim, earns himself a trip to the line. A transfer from South Dakota State, averaging 18 points and 7 rebounds a game. You have to assume he was a first-team all-conference performer. I don't know that for sure. He goes 2 for 2 at the line. Van Dyke back on the bench with those two fouls, so Anthony Brown running the show at the point. Right out top again. They do get a high post catch this time for Jones McCrary. Back to right on the zoom action, and Ed to the cup. Inside hand layup is good. Back-to-back buckets for Ed Wright. Peru State going to slow things down once again. They really want to control this tempo. They've done a good job of that. Pioneers want to play in the 80s and 90s. I think Peru would be content to play in the 70s. Wingett Jr. got baseline on Bosch, and Bosch going to pick up the foul. He's going to send Wingett right back to the free throw line for a 1-1. Both teams in the bonus now, but I believe Van Dyke the only Pioneer with two fouls. And Wingett left this one short. Credit Ryan Robinson whooping away in the corner for the missed free throws, as he's been doing for a decade plus. Ed to the cup again. Three straight layups for Ed Wright. You don't average 20 points a game on accident, shooting 50% from the floor, 40% from three, and 90% from the free throw line if you can't really score it. And Ed Wright can fill it up. Six straight. Savon Trailer, shot fake, got inside, and Wright blocked it away from behind. It's good scouting report defense, too, because Savon Trailer, a 45% three-point shooter, and the vast majority of his shots are from three. So Ed able to run him off the line that time, make him put it on the floor, and do something else besides catch and shoot. Gets the block shot from behind. Pope one-on-one with Jones McCrary. Drop steps. Good defense inside from Caleb. And unbelievable, with the shot clock expiring and nowhere to go, Amir Pope scores his sixth and seventh points of this first half. Although they've come on quite a few field goal attempts. Wright refuses a double ball screen. Stop and pop off the glass. Make it eight straight for the leading scorer in the heart of America. Junior college All-American. It should be an NAI All-American this season. Would be a crime if he and Anthony Brown aren't both on an All-American team. It's a nice 15-foot pull-up from Ajante Hogan. He's done that a couple times against the zone. He's got seven off the bench. Jones McCrary gets a flare screen for Ed Wright in the corner. One-on-one with Hogan, and now Ed going to throw a skip pass. Brooks Langer thought about a three. Instead, it feeds the post. Caleb one-on-one with Pope. Lefty jump hook up and in. Jones McCrary just goes right through the chest of Pope and gets the offhand jump hook. He's got 8 points. Under 2 minutes to play. Pioneer shows zone. They may have matched up out of it. Ty Griggs was fouled on the floor by Langer, and that's going to send him to the line for a 1-1. We'll see Isaiah Cole right back in. Griggs gets the first. Good for the Pioneers to get punched in the mouth early in that 10-0 start. This is a team that's been winning just about every night by 20, 25, 30 plus at times, and needed to get challenged, respond to some adversity, and they've done that. Battled their way back to a 35-30 lead with a minute and a half to go in the first half. Jones McCrary, high post catch, and Pote is trying to deny him the ball all the time. He's fouling every single possession before the catch. They've just let it go. Now one-on-one inside, Caleb, late shot clock. Gonna have to take a contested turnaround, and it goes out of bounds. Be Peru State basketball. And Pioneer's gonna match back up man-to-man. Be Isaiah Cole guarding the ball. Ty Griggs brings it across the timeline. Little box set. They're trying to get a post touch for Wingett. They do, but way outside, about 18 feet. Pioneers run at Trailer. Throws the extra pass to Griggs. Griggs inside. Pretty shot fake. Got Ed right off his feet, but missed the layup. And there is a 5-6 second difference between shot and game clock. And Pioneer is going to be content to use all 30 seconds of that shot clock. and hopefully not allow Peru State a quality possession here to end the half. Right on the zoom action, into the paint, turnaround jumper. This one wide left, and Peru got 10 seconds. I'm sure if they know it, walking the ball to midcourt. Five now to play. Wingett one-on-one with Anthony Brown. Drives baseline and off his feet. That is such a tough shot. It's a two by David Wingett Jr. Had his toes on the line. Peru State coaching staff asking the officials to look at it and see if it was a two or a three. But a highly contested fadeaway jumper in the corner from Wingett. And for now, it's a 35-32 lead for the Pioneers at halftime of the semifinals of the Hart Conference Tournament. Be back for the second half of action in the Cook Center on MNUSports.com, MNU Sports on YouTube. Welcome back into the Cook Center, where we're set for the second half of action between your host, the number one seed and regular season Heart Conference champs, the Mid-American Nazarene Pioneers, and the visiting Peru State Bobcats. And Peru jumped out to an early 10-0 lead, and we're all over the Pioneers to get this one started. Mid-America had led for the final, 10 minutes of the first half. It's been a back-and-forth ball game between two pretty evenly matched teams, honestly. I mean, Pioneers have had just an outstanding regular season, but this Peru State team, when they've got this whole lineup out there together, is a handful. David Wingett Jr. starts the second half exactly like he ended the first one, hitting a jump shot, and we're tied at 35. Wingett has 9 now. Anthony Brown attacks the closeout on the catch, missed the floater, and tapped in his own miss. That one rattled out. I thought it was going down for sure. It didn't. And Carlos Hines, in transition, steps right by Van Dyke for the easy two. And Ajante Hogan, Savon Traylor in the backcourt, steals the inbounds pass. And the second half starting a lot like the first half did. All Peru State. Hines sat much of the first half with those three fouls. The Pioneers will look to go at him early. They double the post on the dribble when Wingett puts it on the floor. He finally misses a jump shot. Pioneers come up with a stop. They may have their first opportunity to actually run what they called coming out of the timeout of halftime. Van Dyke refused the ball screen, flipped it up to Jones McCrary, who couldn't get the bunny to go. That's two good looks inside now for the Pioneers. That didn't drop. They'll continue to execute, take those shots. Box set. It's a post up for Savon Traylor. Posting up Ed Wright. Traylor with some height advantage there, but Ed holds his own in the post, and that ball hits every part of the rim and finally rolls in for Traylor, who's got 5. Split action from Wright and Van Dyke. Van Dyke goes back door. Ed Wright all alone, top of the key, and he missed it. Thought it may have been deflected. It was not. So it's Peru State basketball. Yeah, you don't see Ed miss that badly very often, and it had some weird spin on it. I think Peru State defender may have got a fingernail to it, but either way, it's Bobcat basketball. They go right inside to Wingett. Van Dyke there to steal it away. He got it to Jones McCrary, who throws it ahead of everybody to Ed Wright for the easy layup. Great play from Van Dyke to come up with the steal, and a good full court pass from Jones McCrary. Pioneers leading scorer Ed Wright now in double figures with 10. It's going to be a size mismatch somewhere on the floor with how big this Peru State team is. Pioneers had to switch some ball screens and ended with Van Dyke guarding a 6'7 in the post. Ball seemed to me like it went off a Bobcat, but Peru State going to maintain possession on the baseline. Carlos Hines gets a ball screen and a switch, takes a contested pull-up two way off the mark. Hines, such an athletic player in transition, has struggled shooting it from the perimeter today. Right, Jones McCrary in that empty side ball screen. It's time to help came in time. We saw Caleb get an easy dunk on that exact same action in the first half. He scored it this time anyway, but it was a much more difficult contested two. And Anthony Brown just stepped on a foot going back in transition, rolled his ankle. That's not great news. We've seen a couple of guys come up gimpy here in this semifinal game. Pote traveled. Yep. Amir Pote on the pick and roll. Took an extra step on that gather, and far side official right on it. Tied at 39. Jake Alexander went to the scores table and then came back. I think the intent there was to take Anthony Brown out and check out the ankle, but Ants said he's fine, didn't want to come out of the game. Caleb is looking to go backdoor to Bosch. It was deflected back into the hands of Van Dyke. And there, Gerard saving Jones McCrary on the high low. That's a great play from Bosch. Went up and saved a turnover for a in-traffic catch. and was cut off on the baseline, spun back to that right hand and scored it again with the weak hand. He's got 9, himself a big game. He's tasked often with guarding the other team's best interior player, and he's been matched up on Wingett Jr. quite a bit. Forced to stop that time. Now Brown in transition, Euro step, floater, he got it. I want to know how many of his 2,400 points have come with that right-handed floater. It's a bunch of them. He's got just 6 here tonight, but Pioneers now lead by 4. Bobcats looking to post the mismatch. They had Titty in on Van Dyke. Hines casts up another 3, no good. And Pote battles through 3 Pioneers for the offensive rebound and got it back to Wingett. And the extra possession results in a 3 from Wingett Jr. He has found his rhythm offensively. He's got 12 points now, and it's a 1-point ball game. Timeout Pioneers, 15:07 to play, 43-42 lead. Pioneer ball with a 1-point lead after the timeout, and Peru State showing full court press. Soft double team came. Pioneers break it easily. Back to a man-to-man. Just enough to make you think about it. You're going to go to Ed Wright at the elbow. Here comes a little elbow ball screen. Jones McCrary on the pick and roll to the rim. Gets it to go, and he's fouled and 1. Beautiful execution from the Pioneers on the after timeout. Completely cleared out that left side. Got Ed Wright a catch at the elbow, and Ed and Caleb with a 2-man game. Pick and roll from 15 feet, so tough to guard, and there's nobody in that corner to come over and help. Jones McCrary finishes the and 1. Bonus free throw, no good. So it's a 3-point lead. Carlos Hines goes to trailer right side. Isolation for Wingett. Double team came and cut from Hines, but Pioneer's able to rotate out of it. Now Hines left all alone in the corner. His 3, no good. 0 for a few from downtown now for Carlos Hines. Step up screen in transition. Hines poked it away from Anthony Brown. That should be Pioneer basketball. It is. Good hands. Good hands from Carlos Hines, but Pioneers keep possession. We'll get Jake Alexander back into the ballgame now. Van Dyke will take a seat. And 1-on-1 in the post. No help came. They're going to leave Wingett on an island. Anthony got to that turnaround jumper. It just rolls out. Another extra possession for the Pioneers on the offensive glass. Right, snakes off the ball screen. 2 on the ball, couldn't get rid of it. Good ball pressure from Hines. Jones McCrary had it poked away by Pope. Good transition defense. Forced Peru State to play in the half court. And the one guy you don't want to see with the ball in his hands has it now at 15 feet on the right side. Double team comes. And get out of it. Hines attacking Bosch from up top. Great defense by Gerard Bosch. Hines got to that stride stop, but Gerard didn't bite on a single one of those head fakes. Turning defense into offense. Anthony Brown throws it the length of the floor. Ed Wright running the floor for the easy 2. 47-42 lead now. Can't harp on that enough, how good a defensive play that was from Gerard Bosch. Staying down on 2 or 3 head fakes after the stride stop from Carlos Hines. And then Alexander jumps the passing lane, just about got a steal. Hines going to take a seat now. Skylar Wilson back in for Peru State. Gets a ball screen out top. Pioneers forced to switch because Wingett, a pick and pop threat. Downhill drive from Hogan rattles out on the layup attempt. Couple stops in a row now, strung together by the Mid-America defense. Double ball screen for Wright. Uses step back. The crossover all the way to the cup, dropped it off for Jones McCrary. That's a nice take by Ed Wright. It would have been an assist, but he was fouled on the floor. And Ed gets dancing with the ball out top. That is not a place you want to be as a defender one-on-one on an island at 20 feet. And Ed starts to find his rhythm. He comes off a zoom action, spins, enters the post to Bosch. And Gerard lost it out of bounds. Peru State basketball. A tough matchup. The freshman going at the fifth-year senior there. Bosch doing a great job on the defensive end. And he's capitalized anytime Wingett has not been guarding him on the offensive end. But Wilson into the paint. Now Wingett one-on-one with Alexander. Here comes the double team. Bit late. Turns the corner, extra pass. They're going to find Hogan all alone for three. No good. Anthony Brown, the rebound in the full court, quick outlet. Jones McCrary was there, and he had it stripped away from behind. Unfortunate for your Pioneers. Caleb was ahead of everybody, had to come back for the ball. Had it stolen away in a transition three from Savon Traylor. Traylor, not a guy you can give any clean catch and shoot threes to. A 45% shooter from downtown. Jones McCrary one-on-one with Hogan, goes right through him. Good move on the baseline side. Caleb going to go to the line for two. Caleb converts on the first of two. Splits the pair, but guess who? Jake Alexander, the senior from McPherson, steals another extra possession. Bosch drives in. He's going to be whistled for the offensive foul. Drove in hard on the baseline. Peru State able to cut him off, took it in the chest. I think it was sold very well by the defender. May have been down close to that restricted area, but he was the primary defender, so restricted area doesn't come into play there. Like it would if he was a help side defender. Second on Bosch. Low foul count for both teams here in the second half. Pote one-on-one inside with Jones McCrary. Had it up and in on the left side, and a foul called on Caleb, and I can't believe it. Jones McCrary was just standing straight up and down, vertical. That's a tough whistle on the senior first team all-conference and defensive, all-defensive team, I should say, from Raytown South. Picks up his second. The bonus free throw no good from Pope. But it's just a one-point game in the Cook Center. Brown goes to Ed Wright. Now triggers that offense out of the high post with Jones McCrary. Pioneers get a switch. Wilson and Anthony Brown. Ball screen comes and uses it into the paint. And he's fouled by Skylar Wilson. For a moment there, Anthony was passing that to Jones McCrary, but he was fouled on the floor. Four team fouls on Peru State, just two on the Pioneers. Anthony gets it to the mid post to Jones McCrary. One on one there with Pope. Double team comes. Caleb spins. Right handed jump hook. No good. Alexander crashing the offensive glass again, was pushed in the back. Officials missed it. This is a very physical Peru State team. They really always are. A lot of good athletes on the floor. And not shy with contact, that's for sure. Pioneers missed the layup. Peru State 3-on-1 break. Hogan going to get the easy dunk. And Ajante Hogan puts the Bobcats back on top by one. It's 49-48 Peru State. Just about 10 minutes to go in the ballgame. Brown thought about a three behind the screen. Gets it inside to Caleb, and he goes up and over Winkett. Gets the jump hook to go. Good feed from Anthony Brown. Took advantage of the switch. Caleb's leading all scorers with 15. And we're trading leads here. Skylar Wilson just lost it. Fumbled it out of bounds. That'll bring us to the under 10 media timeout. It's a one-point lead for Mid-American Nazarene, 50, Peru State 49, in the semifinals of the Hart Conference Tournament. Pioneer basketball in what is effectively the fourth quarter of the semifinal game with a 50-49 lead. Pioneers try to go right inside to Jones McCurry on the after timeout play. Ed Wright set a little rip screen for him, and Langer tried to feed the post some traffic there. They're going to say Caleb touched it last. So we'll see the full court 2-2-1 zone, likely back into that 2-3. Pioneers will press a lot of times after the made free throw, but they had a dead ball there. Why not set your press and get back into the zone? Give a different look here. You've got to find number 5 and number 10 in the black jerseys. There are certainly other guys out there capable, but those two shoot it so well from behind the three-point line. Winget steps through, missed the 15-foot jumper. Good defensive possession. The press in the zone changed the tempo there. Peru State not ready for it. Pioneers steal a stop. Langer gets it to Jones McCrary, and good execution. Got Anthony Brown a wide open three, and it just rattles out. Pioneers going to stay in that 2-3 zone until Peru forces them to get out of it. High post catch from Pote. Goes right at Jones McCrary inside. Caleb stays vertical, but Pote gets the drop step and the layup to go. He's in double figures now with 11. This is a guy that averages just 3 points a game. Don't think he played a lot early. He's been starting lately, but there's Jones McCrary on the answer. The pick and roll to the rim. Another nice pass from Anthony Brown, and Caleb now with 17 points after the dunk. Maybe a nominee for the Olathe Eye Care Good Vision play of the game there. The connection from the two seniors, the two first-team all-conference players for your Pioneers. Anthony runs Winget off the three-point line. He gets inside. He's fouled. The lefty will go to the line for two. I think they're going to get Anthony Brown. They will. It's his second. Wingate connects to tie this game at 52 with 8:08 to play. And he hits them both. Peru State back on top by one. Zoom action for Ed Wright. Hesitates, gets into the paint, and goes right past Wilson, but couldn't get the layup to go. Got himself just a little too deep on the baseline. Couldn't use the backboard on the finish. Wilson going to set the offense against the 2-3 zone. Wingate left all alone in the corner, and he missed the three. Very fortunate defensive possession that time. Not a guy you want to leave open. And Brown pulls down the rebound, brings it across himself. And there's a switch now. Trailer switched on to Jones McCurry. Anthony Brown goes by Pope. Kicks to three for Jake Alexander. And how did that not go in? Rattles out. Hogan comes down with the rebound. Two-three zone stays on. Wilson gets a catch in the paint. Drops one off back door and the dunk from Pope. Pioneer's going to take a timeout, talk things over as they find themselves behind by three with 6:59 to go in the ballgame. You're watching the semifinals of the Hart Conference Tournament here in the Cook Center, MNUSports.com, MNU Sports on YouTube. Brandon Van Dyke back in for the Pioneers to run the point guard spot for the final 7 minutes of this one. They're going to overload a side, try to get a post touch for Jones McCrary. They do. Good execution. Pope going to pick up the foul. His third personal. Might be the 30th foul he's committed in the ballgame. It's the third one they called. Just an incredibly physical player. Caleb spins baseline, lefty jump hook, no good, and Bosch was flying in for the offensive rebound, couldn't come down with it. Peru State going to be very intentional about the pace of this final 6.5 minutes. Want to slow things down, play a half-court game. They have Van Dyke matched up on Wingate Jr. That's a tough matchup. Trailer into the paint, floater, it's good. Peru State now taking a 5-point lead as Trailer in double figures with 10. Brown gets a screen from Jones McCrary. Working right to left. He's fouled. Couldn't get it to go, but ain't going to go to the line for two. Good to see Anthony Brown, the part player of the year, staying aggressive. He just has 6 points, but he's done a lot of playmaking off the dribble. Assists inside to his bigs off the screens. Pioneer's going to need Ant to get going in the scoring column as well if they're going to come back and win this one, and they're certainly capable of that. As Anthony knocks down the first of two. one for two at the line. So it's a four-point lead for the Bobcats. Under 6 minutes to play. Wilson walks it across half court. Gets a screen from Wingett. There's the switch they want. We want to go inside to him with Van Dyke matched up, and they do. Help going to have to come. It does, and it turned over. Peru State trying to cut against that help and get an easy layup. Pioneers rotate, force the turnover. Ant turns down the three, puts it on the deck. Pioneers get the switch. It's Jones McCrary matched up with Wingett. Not giving up a ton of size, but certainly a little bit. Bosch off the weak side cut was fouled, no whistle. Alexander was fouled, no whistle. The third shooting foul of the possession finally called, and Caleb Jones McCrary will go to the line. Amir Pote whistled for the personal. Goodness. Gerard Bosch was hit on the forearm on the initial floater. Jake Alexander was hit in the head on the putback. Finally, Jones McCrary there for the third time. Go to the free throw line as Pope finally picks up his fourth foul. Caleb left the free throw well short. Ed Wright will check back in for the Pioneers. Van Dyke will take a seat. Caleb misses both on that trip, but the Pioneers will be in the bonus the rest of the way. Peru State with those 17 fouls. Pioneers going to have to string some stops together. Double ball screen for Wilson. Trying to get a mid-post catch. They do. Bosch to Wingett. Wilson probing on the deck. Late shot clock now. Pioneers will switch any screen that comes. Wilson stayed down. Thought he traveled. He didn't. Kicked it out to Titian for three. No good. There's a stop the Pioneers needed. Got an answer on the offensive end. They've got it in the hands of the leading scorer in the conference, Ed Wright. Into the paint. Floater over Titian. No good. And Christian pulls down the rebound. 4.5 to play. Peru playing a very deliberate pace, walking it up, starting their possession around the 20-second mark every single time, and getting that guy right there, David Wingett Jr., a touch on every possession, and that's pretty good coaching. Alexander, good hands, stripped it away from behind, but they're going to whistle him for a personal. His third. Just the fourth team foul on the Pioneers. Jake now with three. Nobody else with more than two for the Pioneers. Hogan, jump hook, got it to go. Ajante Hogan in double figures with 11. Anthony, double drag ball screen, attacking Wingett into the paint. Missed it well short. Peru State 3-on-1 break. Hogan gets the alley-oop dunk off the feed from Wingett Jr. Pioneers take a timeout, going to talk things over. Trailing by 8, it's 61-53, under 4 minutes to play in the ballgame. know, this is a game where the Pioneers, really for the first time, and of course they miss him every night, but are missing point guard Makai Elmore out with that broken foot. Because you play a team like Peru State who can switch every screen, takes you out a little bit of your regular offense. You got to play a lot more one-on-one, and Makai could just break anybody down off the bounce, get to the paint. And Pioneers have not lost a game in his absence, but this is the style of game and where you feel it a little bit more. Brown one-on-one with Wilson. Double team comes, pick the dribble up, turns baseline, and an offensive foul on Anthony Brown. Skylar Wilson draws the charge. Wilson going to walk it up across midcourt. There will be 3 minutes left in this ballgame when this possession ends. And Peru State has a chance to make it a double-digit deficit. Wingett one-on-one with Bosch. Kicks the trailer right back on a repost, but at the three-point line, and Wingett's three, no good. Pioneers get a stop they desperately need, but have to pick the pace up offensively. Bosch gets it inside, one-on-one with Wingett. Goes right through him, right-handed jump hook. Not there, but an offensive rebound again. Steals an extra possession. Got it to Alexander. Jake inside to Jones McCrary, who's fouled by Traylor. Great post position by Caleb Jones McCrary. He had 2 feet in the paint and was begging for the basketball. Jake able to find him, and Traylor had no choice but to just wrap him up. Caleb, who leads the Pioneers in scoring tonight with 17, back at the free throw line for a 1-1, and he missed the front end. That's three straight missed free throws for Caleb here in the second half. Front end of a 1-1 is big. 2.5 minutes to play, down by 8. This is a Pioneer team, averages about 90 points a game, has broke the 100-point mark a whole bunch of times, sitting at 53. Some of that cold shooting, but got to give a lot of credit to Peru State defensively. A really tough shot on the turnaround from Wingett. Rattles out. Here comes Anthony Brown in transition. Gets downhill. Bumped. Got the layup to go and one. That's the spark the Pioneers desperately needed. Titian commits the foul, his third. Pote will check back in for him. Anthony will be at the line for one more. In a late game, you got to start thinking about free throws being massive for both teams. Peru State hangs on to this lead. Not yet. You're certainly going to try to get a couple more stops. But a couple guys out there are 50% free throw shooters. You could start fouling a Titian or a Pote in late game situations. Wilson off a high ball screen, and Wright got under it. It's Wingett Jr. again, and his usage rate tonight is through the roof. He's touching it every single time down. Traylor one-on-one with Jake Alexander. Two seniors battling on the block, and Jake commits the foul. Traylor got him off his feet. It's the fourth personal on Alexander, and Savon Traylor will go to the line for two. An excellent three-point shooter, a 77% free throw shooter. Trying to clean up a wet spot there where Traylor went down. Student section trying to will a miss from Traylor. He's unfazed. Nothing but net on the first of two. And Savon Traylor got them both. 63-56, a minute 40 to go. Brown, pistol action to right. Turns the corner, getting baseline, and Anthony Brown gets the quick layup to go. 5 quick points from Anthony Brown, and it's a 63-58 game with a minute 32 to play. We'll take a quick timeout. Semifinals of the Hart Conference Tournament. MNUSports.com, MNU Sports on YouTube. Good execution by the Pioneers on the last trip down. Little pistol set. Got Anthony Brown downhill for the two. They're going to have to come up with a couple of more stops, though. Trailing by 5. Full court press. Double team comes. And a long pass, but Skylar Wilson able to come down with it. And Peru State breaks the press. Ed Wright going to be whistled for the foul. He got two hands in the back of Skylar Wilson there. And that'll send a nearly a 90% free throw shooter, Skylar Wilson, to the free throw line. It is a 1-1, 17 foul on the Pioneers. Not a guy who misses a whole lot of free throws. And rattles out. So Pioneers get a de facto stop after the missed free throw. Here's a pistol set once again. Crack back for Ed Wright. 3 on the way from the ring. Just missed it. Anthony got a hand on the offensive rebound, but couldn't quite come down with it. And Peru State going to go right back to the line for a 1-1. Decent execution there. Pioneers ran the pistol action again. This time got Ed Wright, their best three-point shooter, on a little crackback for a fairly clean look. Sometimes they don't go down. That's part of it. It's going to send a Jonte Hogan to the line. He's a 79% free throw shooter. Front end of the 1-1. Got it. Hogan goes 1-for-2. Still a two-possession game. Minute 10 to play. Step up screen from Wright. He gets a flare. Brown working one-on-one with Wilson. Into the paint. Kicks. Was looking for Jake Alexander in the corner, and it was stolen away by Ajonte Hogan. That's a huge turnover. Pioneer's going to have to foul. Trailer double-teamed at midcourt. Timeout comes from Peru State.
Timeout, Peru State.
50.6 to go in the ball game. It's a 64-58 lead. Timeout, Bobcats. Peru State gets it inbounds to Carlos Hines. Quick double team comes, and Jones McCrary commits the foul. Left his feet, trying to get a hand on the ball, hoping for an errant pass. Hines will go to the line for 1-1. And Hines has been on the bench for quite some time. It's not an easy task to come in cold, go right to the free throw line. Hines has been plagued with foul trouble most of this evening. And he gets the front end of the 1-1 to go. Make it 65-58, Peru State. And Hines got them both. So it is now an 8-point lead for the Bobcats with 48 seconds to play. Pioneers will roll it all the way to midcourt. Anthony Brown will pick it up there. Gets a double ball screen, looking for Ed Wright on a pick and pop. Peru State switches, Brown to the rim, fouled, and gonna go to the line for two. It was a question of one or two. Gonna be two, as couldn't get the and one to go. Wilson picks up the personal, his second.
Anthony Brown at the line, shooting two.
This switching defense from Peru State, where they switch almost every ball screen and dribble handoff interchange, has caused some issues offensively here tonight for the Pioneers. Now, late in the game, Anthony Brown's been able to get into the paint. Jones McCrary's taken advantage of the switches at times, but again, a team averaging 90 in the 50s with under a minute to play. Some great defensive effort from Peru State. Brown got them both, so it's still a two-possession game. 6 points. Hines got Ed right off of his feet, and Isaiah Cole is going to foul Ajante Hogan, and he'll go to the line for two. So it's double bonus the rest of the way for both teams.
Zero, Isaiah Cole. That's his first 10th team foul. Ajante Hogan at the line, shooting two.
Ajante Hogan, who's had a big night off the bench, couple of highlight plays, 14 points, misses the first of two. And Coach Hepker going to call a timeout, make him think about the second one, and set something up offensively for his group. So 37.9 to go, 6-point lead for the Bobcats. For his second free throw attempt, and he missed them both. So it is still a two-possession game. Still some hope for the Pioneers. Ed Wright off the pin down from the slot. Long three, he banked it in. He banked it in. The shot clock is off. Pioneers get a full timeout. And it's a one-possession game. Coach Hepker got the officials' attention finally and is fired up. Almost didn't get the timeout called. But Ed Wright banks in a three, and it is a 66-63 ball game. Shot clock will be off because 29.2 to play. So Pioneer's going to have to force a turnover or foul. But this game just got extended by the junior from Lorain, Ohio. Officials are taking a look to see if that was a two or a three. I think it was clearly a three. Or they could be potentially watching the monitor to see how much time should be on the clock. We'll see. But it'll be Pioneers in the full court press trailing by one possession when we come back. So obviously, the full court press is on. Gerard Bosch is guarding the ball. Isaiah Cole, Ed Wright, Anthony Brown, Caleb Jones, McCrary denying inbounds. They put a full 30 seconds back on. So, oh, that should be a turnover. That's Pioneer basketball. Wingett Jr. was trying to throw it to Carlos Hines in the corner. Anthony Brown was right there, and it was deflected out of bounds. Last touch by Peru State, and Pioneers steal the possession right back. Unbelievable turn of events. Just 0.6 comes off the clock. So Anthony Brown going to have to inbound from the dead corner, but the Pioneers have the basketball in a one-possession game. Brown has to just throw it up top to Jones McCrary. He gets it to Ed Wright on the dribble handoff. Ed working on Wingett. Attacks. Gets the easy layup. Missed the easy layup, but tipped in by Jones McCrary. Anthony Brown commits the foul. Peru State coaching staff thought that may have been offensive interference on Jones McCrary. I think they may have a complaint. That ball was either on the rim or had just got out of the cylinder. But Jones McCrary gets credit for the tip-in. And we got a one-point game with Skylar Wilson going to the line for two. Wilson, a 90% free throw shooter, but he did miss one earlier in the second half. Calmly knocks down that one to make it a two-point lead for Peru State. As it has gotten awfully loud in the Cook Center as Wilson gets ready to shoot. The students trying to will another miss from a great shooter. Two-point lead for Peru State. And Wilson knocks down both. It's a three-point game. Full court press from Peru. And Pioneers take a timeout. That's their last timeout. And they'll have to go the length of the floor against Peru, probably in a full court press, trailing by three. 20 and a half seconds to go in the ballgame. MNUSports.com. Your three seniors, Jake Alexander, Anthony Brown, Jones McCrary, on the floor with Ed Wright and Gerard Bosch. Trailing by three, no timeouts left. Full court press from Peru. Wright gets the inbounds. He takes it across. He's going to go coast to coast, and he lays it in. 94 feet in about 6 seconds. Ed Wright gets the layup. Peru State, before you can blink, inbounds it to the right guy, Skylar Wilson. Going to go right back to the free throw line. Just knocked down a pair. Man, how fast was Ed Wright down the floor there against a full court press? Just full head of steam downhill, got the layup. Playing a free throw game with a 90% free throw shooter here. And Skylar Wilson, nothing but the bottom of the net. Missed his first one in the second half and has made three straight. And the second free throw rattles in, but it's a three-point lead once again for the Bobcats. Hines denying Ed Wright the ball. Ed got it anyway. He brings it across. A trailing Anthony Brown. Three from the top of the key. Back rim, no good. Bosch tried to tip it out. Hines came down with the rebound. And that ball's going to be heading to the free throw line. Carlos Hines was fouled on the baseline. lead. That's a tough finish there, as Pioneers really did get a good look. Got Conference Player of the Year Anthony Brown a deep but fairly uncontested three that had a chance to tie it, and it looked good all the way, just back rim. Less than a second to go, 0.7 on the clock. Carlos Hines is going to be at the line. Jake Alexander picked up his fifth personal. And he exits the game, but two missed free throws and a miracle full court lob is the only chance now for your regular season champs, and that will put the icing on the cake as Hines makes the free throw. It's a four-point game, and Peru State goes to Central Methodist in the quarterfinals, comes out with a win, comes into the 17-game win streak, number 10-ranked Pioneers in the semifinals, and goes out with a win. And they're one win away from a Heart of America Conference Tournament Championship and a trip to the national tournament. So hats off to a good Peru State team playing well at the right time. Pioneers 17-game win streak comes to an end in the semifinals, but they will be in the national tournament, will await seeding and matchups. But an unbelievable season from your Pioneers, and we'll be back in the Cook Center for the national tournament for the first time in program history. Thanks for tuning in to NewsSports.com.